Let me hear you.
I don't want to.
Chanson. Go ahead.
Go ahead.
No, go.
No, go ahead.
And that chanson. Let me hear you.
Chanson.
Chanson.
I don't want to do this.
Chanson pour les petits enfants.
This is embarrassing. Just say the name.
Chanson pour les petits enfants.
Okay. What year was it?
What?
What year?
What year was that? Would have been, I think, 1978 when we sailed into... Oh, you're strangling your dog. No, you're not.
Chanson.
See if that's right. I think that's when we got to... Well, I wrote it the first time I sailed into St. Barts.
You did?
Yep. Well, I wrote it that year because...
It was on... Volcano, 1979.
79. So I wrote. So I got there in like 78.
Mm-hmm.
So the story was, this is sailing down there, and this is on Euphoria 2, which is a 48 Charlie Clipper that Groovy and I, and I think Tom Corcoran and maybe one other person came in and out, but we sail from Fort Lauderdale through all the Bahamas down through the Turks and Caicos, and across the Anaconda Channel to St. Martin and then to St. Barts. And you gotta remember, there was no internet, there was no virtual anything, but there were sailing guides, sailing books you had on board your book that, you know, they told you not only sailing directions and things that you needed to know and had charts in it, but also told you about the islands, because they were always, you know, you get into the Lesser Antilles, you got French, you got Dutch, you got English, you got Spanish, which was part of the incredible history of the place. We read about it. And that we read about, I remember they had, you know, like fresh croissants in the little bakery for breakfast. And I went, ooh, fresh croissants. Okay, let's go to that island. And literally we did. So we stopped in. We were going to Martinique. We wanted to go to Martinique. And so we stopped in and we just ran into this incredible bunch of sailors. It was a different place in those days. And it was a hangout for smugglers who were pot smugglers and kind of runaways from that old European and French soldiers of fortune. It was really kind of cool. And once again, going from Key West is right up my avenue. And everybody loved music and everybody played music there in the bars and all. And so on the first night we got there, we had come a long way, and it's a whole nother story, but we had saved a couple of fishermen who were lost at sea, and we had taken them back to Anguilla, where they had come from right before all this happened. So by the time we were feeling good that we'd saved these old men, and we got to St. Barts. We didn't know anything. It was late at night. We anchored up, not knowing where we were, and where we actually anchored the first night was in Gouverneur, which you know now, which is not where boats anchor. But it was so calm that day, and I'll never forget, we went ashore, had a barbecue grill, got drunk, had dinner, and woke up the next day to move the boat around with hangovers, and we were in the middle of a whole pod of whales in Gouverneur Bay. So I thought, boy, that's a sign. So we go into the harbor, and as we put our anchor down, this dinghy came over and these kids came up and they had croissants and coffee. And I said, well, thanks. Where are y'all? Do you live here? And they said, no, we live on a boat. My parents have your album on board and we know your songs because we're homeschooled. And it was the Frith children, Mishka, Magnus, and Suzanne Frith. And I got to know those kids and their parents very well. And there were these little, boat rats running around, and cute as they could be. And the funny story, the side story was, on the trip on that boat, there weren't even like VHS players, but I knew somebody in California that could get you bootleg, big like studio movie size cassettes, but they were, you know, as big as a player now. And I got some of them, so you could. When we had a video deck on the boat and a little bitty TV monitor, color monitor, and I don't know why, but we had it. And so, you know, the movies were so big, you could only take about six or seven movies. And so I thought, what am I going to take down there? So I took to Have or Have Not, The Wizard of Oz, a great old movie called Black Orpheus that I love that takes place in Brazil at Carnival, The Man Who Would Be King, It's a Mad, 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 Mad World, and I'm trying to think of the other one. But Wizard of Oz, when these kids had never seen The Wizard of Oz, so I had them on the boat one night with a little bitty color monitor on the boat, and I showed them The Wizard of Oz. And, you know, you thought that they'd died and gone to heaven, you know. And then this one kid, Magnus, says, "Oh, I've been to Oz." I said, "You've been to Oz?" He said, "Yeah." So, "Well, where is it?" He said, "In my mind." So there were those kind of kids, and then getting to know them along the way, I just made up this song with a couple of Nicole was in it, Kino's in it, and it was just, again, you know, on my journey through life, it was a great stop, and turned out to be the place that these days I still consider one of my homes. And the first song I ever attempted to write alone in French. Mr. Moon flew away in the night with his best friend Magnus right by his side. They soared through the Milky Way, counting the stars, once around Venus, twice around Mars. Then they spied an island rise out of the sea and fell back to earth just as big as you please. The children all gathered, the church bells didn't ring. Suddenly everyone started to sing. Chanson pour les petits enfants, chanson pour tout le monde. Chanson pour les petits enfants, chanson pour tout le monde. Now young princes lay apart coral and pearls, gifts to the travelers from some other world. The book doctor mixed up some magical spells for them to see, was he never to. And then our raccoons plucked one, and the mice they brought cheese. Beautiful birds floated by on the breeze. While out in the ocean, the dolphins began. From out of the tomb, they soon covered the land. Chanson pour les petits enfants, chanson pour tout le monde. Chanson pour les petits enfants, chanson pour tout le
digging.